Praise the Lord. Amen. Good to be back to God's house tonight. Amen. We come back to worship Him tonight and give Him some praise, glory, and honor. Amen. I'm excited about what God's doing. Amen. Hey, listen. We're doing something good. Amen. When you're doing something good, the enemy don't like it. Amen. Well, we're doing something good. Amen. We're serving the Lord. Amen. We're giving God praise, giving Him glory and honor. Amen. He said He inhabits our praises. Amen. So when you're doing something good, you know the devil's always going to run in a lovely head. Amen. When he sees people getting blessed and people getting touched and people getting healed, he don't like it. Amen. He just don't like it. But, man, we come to give God praise. We didn't come to put on no show. We don't come to put on no program. Amen. We don't have a stage. We got a pulpit. Amen. We don't believe in actors. Amen. I don't just let anybody get up here behind this pulpit. Amen. Because I know what God told me. And I have to stand by what God told me. Amen. I'm the one going to be standing before God for what I let go on behind here. Amen. And if I didn't think somebody wasn't living right, you think I'd let them behind this pulpit? So what's wrong with living right? Amen. My sister Connie, come open us up in prayer tonight.
Reason that we're here, Lord.
have church tonight. Amen. Hallelujah. The Bible said where two or three are gathered in my name, I'm in the midst. So there's more than two or three here tonight. Amen. The 12th might be some more come in later. Amen. But we just want to praise God tonight.
Page 6, I'll Fly Away. Let's all fly.
Oh,
Everybody knows that.
Leaving her friend's house last night and she hasn't came home. pitiful that you can't even let your children even go somewhere and then not come home. Amen. They still trying to find the girl in Bowling Green, but the other girl, they haven't been on her yet, as far as I know, 13 years old. Amen. So remember those families, because those families are really struggling right now. They're hurting. Their heart is broken because they don't know what happened to their children. Amen. So I ask you to remember those families. Remember Brother Bob Sandlin and By My Holiness Church up in Ohio. Pray for his sister-in-law that God will touch her. Amen. I told Sister Nora the other day, I said, I'm going to try to get a hold of Brother Bob and see if I can't get him to come down here after the first year and preach for us a few nights. I'll tell you, you'll be amazed, because he's a good preacher, ain't he, Brother Wayne? Amen. A real good preacher, and I believe he lives what he preaches. Amen. And but I'm going to try to get a hold of him and see if he would want to come and preach for us some after the first of the year. Brother Kevin said to keep him in prayer. Keep Brother Kevin in your prayers. Amen. Sister Wendy, he needs a touch from God, church. Amen. Been on the battlefield for a long time. If you only know what Brother Kevin used to be and what he is now, amen, he wouldn't trade it for 1 minute. Amen, he wouldn't trade it for 1 minute. Amen, because he knows where God brought him from. Amen, and he wants to give God all that he can give God. Amen. I know it's hard for him, amen, but just pray for him. Amen, that God would touch him. Let him pass that kidney. God can dissolve that kidney stone and just let it pass.
He did
right.
For me.
Amen. I know he can. Amen. I know God can do that. Amen. Right. That's just a little, 9 centimeters. 8 centimeters. Anyway, God can dissolve that down to like a BB. He can just take it all out, bust it up, just let it all be all right. I know who we serve. Amen. You just been, God is so good, you just can't explain how good God is. People say, well, Brother Miller, do you believe God? Yeah, God's still doing that. He's still doing miracles. Yeah. Amen. Even though the world wants to say that God ain't healing nobody, God ain't saving nobody. Listen, just because you don't see somebody saved here, there's somebody on live stream that's getting saved. Somebody out there somewhere is getting saved. Big old line right there. Amen. We don't know how many people have asked God into their heart. We honestly don't. But God does. Amen. When we preach the gospel and the gospel goes forth, the Bible said it'll go and it'll accomplish what it's supposed to do. Amen. It'll go and pierce the hearts of those out there on live stream. It'll go and pierce those ones that gets on there and watches later. Amen. It will pierce their hearts. Amen. If they're on there just for to pick and nitpick, God will pierce their heart. Amen. We just keep on praying. Amen. We love everybody. I don't hate nobody. I don't hate no race, color, or creed. Because God said there's not even in his category, there's no neither male or female, Jew or Greek in his eyes. Amen. In his eyes, we're all one. We're all the same. We was created like who? God. We were created just like him. In his image was we created. He created us. Amen. So when you look in the mirror, you say, there's God. He created us just like him. There's God. I see him every day. Here's, I don't see God. I see him. I see him all around, Brother Michael. When I wake up and I see my wife over there sitting up, checking her blood pressure, I see God. Because he woke her up. Amen. When I don't get a phone call from church people and I know that they woke up, I see God. Amen. I can see him in anything that I want to see him in, I can see him. Amen. Because he's God. I was reading earlier, he said he was an invisible God. Amen. Some people said, well, you can't see. He said, look, you worship him in spirit and in truth. Amen. God's a spirit, and we must worship him in spirit and truth. But he's also creator. created us in his image. So if he created us in his image, he looks like us. Brother Daniel, he's got arms. He's got legs. He's got fingers. Because the Bible says he shoots the lightning down his arms and out his fingertips. So that lets me know he's got hands. And said the clouds was his footprints. Amen. So he's got to have some feet. Amen. So he's a great big God. He's sitting on his throne. He's looking down tonight saying, bless my people. Bless my people. Somebody else got a prayer request.
Given the church, the rest of the church will always follow the leading of the Lord.
Yes, amen. Remember all those up in Louisville, the I-65 northbound's flooded. There in Louisville, they've got a lot of rain. Me and Lord, I showed Lord a picture of it. Amen. It's the water all over I-65. It's just like, where'd that come from? You know, because it's like that low spot there on where you get right into Louisville right there, that low spot. Amen. Traffic all backed up. So pray that nobody gets involved in a wreck or anything. Amen. That everybody makes it through safely. Amen. Somebody else got a prayer request.
Pray for Cuba. They got hit with an earthquake and they felt it all the way into Florida. And also over in the Middle East, I sent it to Michael earlier today. I think it was in Saudi Arabia. They got snow for the first time.
First time.
So the Bible's fulfilling and people just wake up.
That's right. The Bible, listen. The Bible talks of a great earthquake that's going to take place. And when that earthquake takes place, it's going to shake everything. It's going to shake everything. People say, well, Brother Miller, we don't believe in that. Well, you don't believe in the Bible. Yeah. Amen. He said these signs will follow them that
believe.
So if you're a believer, then you know these signs, Sister Connie, are true. They're coming to pass. The Euphrates River is going dry. That's the Bible. That's prophecy. Amen. It's going dry. Amen. The Dead Sea. Guess what? Everybody said, well, no, everything in that Dead Sea is going to come alive. Amen. Read the Bible. Things is going to take place, and it's all going to take place over there in the East, in the Middle East. The Bible said that the mark of the beast would rise up in the East. Not in the west, not in the north, not in the south, but he said in the east. Over there in that country, over there where it's going to rise up, Brother Daniel. He's going to come up. He's going to come up. In other words, he's going to bring him up. And he's going to see many. The Bible said if the very elect be, if be possible, the very elect would be deceived. And have you not seen people being deceived every day right then? The very elect, Brother Daniel, are being deceived. Amen. Church people are being deceived. Because they'd rather to do the easy route than to do the right way. Somebody else got a prayer request. We better hush. We might be getting on Brother Wayne's message. Somebody else. Yeah, pray that we don't run into no water from my little church. Will go under. It'll die out. If it gets in much water, it just dies. Don't it? That's the end of it. Poor little thing. Amen. But pray for us. Amen. That we'll have a safe trip there and a safe trip back. That God will watch over us and everything will be right. And tell us when we go this time that she don't have to come back no more. Amen. It's been 5 years. Amen. Yeah, won't have to come. No, won't have to come back for none. Amen. It's all over. Amen. Hallelujah. Brother Terry Garrett. Amen. He's been watching our live streams. People didn't know that, but Brother Terry Garrett's been watching our live stream. I want y'all to be praying for Brother Terry Garrett. Amen. I pray that God will bless him, touch him. I appreciate them watching us. Amen. Brother Tony and Tina Dean. Amen. And Panama, amen, pray for them. I pray. pray for their church. God will bless them. Brother Tony has been watching our live streams. And the other night, Laura said, Brother Tony's watching. I said, y'all don't want to have Daniel sing. You can't tell me I'm dying. Amen. Because listen, Brother Tony, amen, gave us the rights to sing his songs. Amen. Give us the soundtrack so we can sing his songs. Amen. Because he wants his songs to go out and touch somebody's heart. And that can't tell me I'm dying in order to touch everybody's heart. Amen. Because the devil want to tell you you're going to die, but God said you're not until it's your time. Amen. Also remember Sister Bessie up in Michigan. Remember her family, Sister Lily Harvey and her family. Amen. Pray for them. They need our prayers. Sister BJ, amen, ask for prayers. So remember her tonight. Also remember Brother Jackie Stamps. Lord, I got to talk to him yesterday. Amen. And remember him in prayer. He was asking her how she was doing and praying for her. Amen. Also remember Sister Tammy Brown. Brother Timmy said she is really needs our prayers, church. She is really struggling. Amen. With her breathing. She's got that COPD real bad. She's got congestive heart failure. Amen. The doctors just told her, amen. And she's got some other things that's happening, so like infection and stuff. So pray that God will touch her. Amen. She hasn't got to go to church like she needs to. She loves to be in church, but she watches our live streams. And she thanks the Lord that we pray for her. And I told her we pray every time we can. We try our best to pray for her. Pray for Brother Kenny. He's been having some problems with his chest. Amen. That God will touch him. Also, remember Brother Danny Scrub. Amen. In their church over there in Scottsboro. He's going to get with us and get some things set up for the women of the church to kind of minister. Amen. And So keep that in mind. Remember Brother Kenny Capps also tonight. He's having problems with his feet. Amen. That God will touch him. Remember. Remember him. Also remember Brother Darrell, Sister Francis, and Little Artie. Amen. Out in California. And all them, Sister Marjorie Burke and her family, Sister Judy McCarthy and her family, her husband, amen, has been watching. Amen. Remember Sister Carly Pope and her family and all of her kids, amen, and her grandkids. She's asked prayer for them. Also remember Sister Lynn and her family, Brother Darrell's son Michael and his family, amen. And remember all the new ones that Brother Darrell has told about us, amen, and they're watching. Amen. And I thank God for that. Listen, they're out there, they're battling fires out there. An 18-year-old boy got killed because of the tree fell on him trying to help put out the fire. Amen. So pray that California is burning, church. I'm telling you, it's going up in flames. And you know what? God, when God does something, we can't control God. Amen. When he does something, he does it. Amen. He gets sick and tired of the way things is going. Amen. He'll bring things upon this earth. Amen. They're talking right now that hurricanes and the weather that we're having. Colorado just got 2 foot of snow. Amen. Colorado just got 2 foot of snow. Amen. Oklahoma got snow. Amen. This time of the year they done got snow. You say, Rob Miller, what are you talking about? Listen. Amen. The weather is changing. The Bible said you wouldn't know the season from season, and it's all changing. Amen. So pray for our land and country. Pray for our leaders. Amen. Pray for our president that's coming up next year. Amen. That God would just use him in a mighty way. If y'all didn't see the vice president and what he was saying, amen, then you need to watch that. Amen. He was talking about the Bible and stuff. Amen. About what the Bible says. And we need to pray for our leaders. Pray for those that ain't saved, that they get saved. Amen. Pray for that one that says Jesus is a little Jesus. You want to go to that little Jesus, go over to that other one. Amen. Listen, there ain't but one Jesus, and he's bigger than anybody.
Amen.
Amen. He's bigger than all of our problems and all of our trials. He's bigger than that. Amen. And I tell people, I said, hey, he's a big God. Amen. And his son's a big son. Amen. He gave him power over heaven and earth. He's got power. Amen. Because he's a big, big, big son of God. Amen. People say, well, he's just, no, he's a big Jesus. Amen. And I love Jesus. Amen. He loves us, but he don't like some of the things we do every once in a while because he'll get on to us. He'll scold us. Amen. He chastises us. I told somebody the other day, I said, I'd rather get whooped by somebody else than get whooped by God.
All right. Amen.
Amen, Brother Michael. I've been whooped by God many times. Mm-hmm. Man, you go, you feel like you're dying. You feel like you're drying up, Sister Miss. You feel like, man, what have I done? What have I done? And you apologize and apologize. 70 times 7. God, I'm sorry. God, I'm sorry. God, I'm sorry. I had somebody tell me, he said, well, you always pray for everybody. I said, why do you? I said, because I call everybody out. I pray for people. Amen. I even ask God to forgive me every day. I said, Lord, if I've done anything wrong, forgive me. I'm sorry. If I've sinned against you in any way, forgive me. Well, you shouldn't do that every day. Well, why not? Paul did. Paul denied himself daily. Deny means he asked God to forgive him. Amen. Anybody else got a prayer request? Amen. Remember Big Old Live tonight. Remember all those that's watching my live stream. Amen. That God will move in a mighty way tonight. Brother Wayne preached a good message the other night. And I know he's got another tonight. Amen. Just get in tonight and pray for Brother Wayne. Pray for the singers tonight, the saints. Hey, we're just family. We're having church. When you become a bride of Christ, you're family. Amen. I don't care. We're not blood kin. We're still family. Amen. I miss Sister Teresa and Brother Gary tonight. I miss Sister Charlotte. I miss Sister Darlene and Lori and Brother Morse. Amen. I miss them. Brother Johnny and Sister Sherry. I miss them. Amen. Sister Jackie. Amen. We miss them. When I'm sitting here and I'm looking, and I don't see them smiling faces. I miss people, amen. And when they're sick, I hurt. Amen. I pray for them. Amen. And, just pray for each other tonight. Pray for each other's family. Amen. If you ain't got nothing else to pray for Sister Moore. She does need it, amen. She does. She needs prayer. A lot of people don't realize what she been going through. She's like me. She don't try to let everybody see how she really does hurt and things, but she does. She prays for the church too. Don't get me wrong. Amen. She prays for the church. I'll be sitting over and I'll hear her over and she got them headphones on. And she's watching the church service and she's shouting at home after we leave the church. She's over there speaking in tongues, praying for the church folk. Amen. And just remember her in prayer. Amen. Unspoken quest by the raising of your hands. Pray to see to pray to y'all.
Thank you. Brother Michael. He's our veteran here in the church. Amen. And we want to recognize all our other veterans out there that watch us by live stream. Amen. We want to tell you we appreciate you for your services. Brother Jerry Green. Amen. I told him a while ago I appreciated for him, that he went and fought for our land and country. Amen. That he went over there. Amen. And he fought. Amen. And he's back. He's preaching now for the gospel of God. Amen. So we want to let Brother Wayne and Sister Connie, amen, go ahead and present this to Brother Michael.
I'll give this to you, Brother Michael, for your service and for everything you do for the church, and most of all for your service and the love that you have for our country.
Amen.
Say something. No, it's everybody always says thank you. You know, it's humbling. It's really humbling. Most people can tell thank you for your service in this. Don't thank me, thank the ones that were passed on. No, we thank everybody the same.
That's right.
The ones that passed on just paid the price. They were next to the ones.
Bless you, Lord. Amen.
That's the truth. That's the truth. Amen. That's the same way being in God's army, Sister Bonnie. Amen. They're right there beside them, and the next thing you look, they're coming. Amen. Just call them home. Amen. They fought the fight. Paul said, I fought the fight. I kept the faith. Amen. We all got to fight a fight. He said, amen, to be endure hardness like a good soldier. Amen. It takes good soldiers. Amen. To win an army, it takes a good soldier to win a war. Amen. It takes a good Navy, a good Marine. Amen. A good Airborne. Amen. It takes the National Guard Armory. Amen. You don't think they put them on the firing line? They take the National Guard and they put them out there on the firing line, Brother Michael. That's the first ones they put out there is the National Guard Armory. They train them, and they'll call them up, and they'll put them right out on the front line. Mm-hmm. Ain't you glad that God always got us
protected?
Amen. All right, we're going to take up the offering tonight. Amen. Give what God lays on your heart, and He'll bless you. Amen. And I'm going to ask Brother Michael to come on up. Amen.
All my words for sure, I've got
Thank you.
train them up in the way they should go when they won't depart. Amen. This here is training the children. Amen. When they sing, going to sing for Jesus. Amen. That'll make you happy. Amen. I think Ashley's going to help her. Well, bless you, Jesus. Mom will help me. Amen.
Amen. Hallelujah.
life.
Amen.
Ain't good to know that Jesus changed your life.
Right.
Amen.
And he'll do the same for others.
Right.
Just live. Well, they would ask for this morning. Bring forth fruit for 3 years, and ye shall sow the 8th year,
and eat it oak fruit until the ninth year, until her fruits come. Then ye shall eat of the old store. The land shall not be sold forever, for the land is thine. For ye are strangers and sojourners with me. And in all the land of your possession ye shall grant a redemption for the land. And if thy brother be waxing poor, or have sold away some of his possession, and if any of his kin come to redeem it, then shall he redeem that which his brother sold. And if the man have done none to redeem it, and himself be able to redeem it, then let him count the years of the sale thereof, and restore the overplus unto the man to whom he sold it, that he may return unto his possession. But if he be not able to restore it to him, then that which is sold shall remain in the hand of him that hath bought it until the year of Jubilee. And in the Jubilee it shall go out, and ye shall return unto his possession. And if a man sell a dwelling house in a walled city, then he may redeem within a whole year after it is sold, wherein a full year may he redeem it. And if it be not redeemed within the space of a full year, then the house that is in the walled city shall be established forever to him that bought it throughout his generation. It shall not go out until the Jubilee. But the houses of the villages which have no wall round about them shall be counted as the fields of the country. They may be redeemed, and they shall go out in the Jubilee, notwithstanding the cities of the Levites and the houses of the cities of their possessions may the Levites redeem at any time. And if a man purchase of the Levites, then the house that was sold and the city of his possessions shall go out into the year of Jubilee. For the houses of the cities, the Levites are the possession among the children of Israel, but the field of the suburbs of the cities may not be sold, for it is the perpetual possession. And if thy brother be waxen poor and fallen in decay with thee, then thou shalt relieve him. Yea, though he be a stranger or sojourneth, that he may live with thee. Take thou no mercy of him or a priest, but fear thy God, that thy brother may live with thee. Thou shalt not give him thy money unto mercy, nor lend the vigil for increase. I am the Lord your God, which brought you forth out of the land of Egypt to give you the land of Canaan, and to be your God. And if thy brother that dwelleth by thee be waxen poor, and be sold unto thee, thou shalt not compel him to serve as bondservant, but as a hard servant, and as sojourning, he shall be without with thee, and shall serve thee until the year of Jubilee. And then shall he depart from thee, both he and his children with him, and shall return unto his own family, and to the possessions of his father shall he return. For they are many servants, are my servants, which I brought out of the land of Egypt. They shall not be sold as bondmen. They shall not rule over him with rigor, but shall fear thy God. But thy bondmen and thy bondsmen, which thou shalt have, shall be of the heathen that are round about you. Of them shall thy bondmen and bondsmen say. Moreover, the children of the strangers that do sojourn among you, of them shall you buy, and of their families that are with you, which they beget in your land, and they shall be your possessions, and ye shall take them as an inheritance for your children after you to inherit them for possession. They shall be your bondmen forever, but over your brethren, the children of Israel. Ye shall not rule one over another with rigor, and if a sojourner or stranger which wax rich by thee, and thy brother that dwelleth by him wax poor and selleth himself, unto the stranger or sojourneth by thee, or the stock of the stranger's family. After that he is sold, he may be redeemed again. One of his brethren may redeem him. Either his uncle or his uncle's son may redeem him. Or any thing, or any that is nigh of kin unto him or of his family may redeem him. Or if he be able, he may redeem himself. And he shall reckon with him that brought him from the year that he was sold to him until the year of Jubilee. And the price of his sale shall be according unto the numbers of years, according to the time of the hard servant shall it be with him. If there be yet many years behind, according to them he shall give again the price of his redemption of the money that he was brought forth. And if their redeemed remain but few years until the year of Jubilee, then he shall count with him, and according to the years, he shall give him again the price of the redemption. And as a yearly hired servant shall he be with him, and the other shall not rule with rigor over him in thy sight. And if he be not redeemed in these years, then he shall go out in the year of Jubilee, both he and his children with him. For unto me the children of Israel are servants. They are my servants, whom I brought forth out of the land of Egypt. I am the Lord thy God. Verses 1 through 22. If you want to, you can go back there and read. I'm going to skip through some of it. It said, and the Lord spake unto Moses in Mount Sinai, saying, speak unto the children of Israel, saying to them, when ye come into the land which I give you, then shall the land keep a Sabbath unto thee. The Lord, 6 years thou shalt sow the field, 6 years thou shalt prune thy vineyard, and gather in the fruit thereof. But in the seventh year shall be a Sabbath of rest unto the land, a Sabbath for the Lord. Thou shalt not neither sow thy field nor to prune thy vineyards. Verse 9 said, then shall I call the trumpet of the Jubilee to sound on the 10th day of the 7th month and the day of atonement. Shall ye make the trumpet sound thereof all your land. And ye shall call the 50th year and proclaim liberty all the land unto all inhabitants thereof. It shall be a Jubilee unto you. And ye shall return every man into his possession. And ye shall return every man into his family. A Jubilee shall that 50th year be unto you. Ye shall not sow, neither reap that which groweth of itself in it, nor gather the grapes in the vineyard, for it is the Jubilee. It shall be holy unto you. Ye shall eat the increase thereof out of the field. And it says here, and it shall be, verse 20, what shall we eat the seventh year? Behold, we shall not sow together in the increase. Verse 22 says, and ye shall sow the eighth year, and eat yet of old fruit until the ninth, until her fruits come in. Ye shall eat of the old store. As you're reading this here, it tells us here that God was telling them to prepare for the Jubilee, church. And as I was walking in the store, I kept hearing Jubilee all day today. And as I was walking in the store there, I heard the Lord say, are you preparing for the Jubilee? And I began to think about some things there about the Jubilee. You know, you look it up, a Jubilee is a special occasion. Yeah. You know, you can look at it, it means you look at 7 years there or 8 years there, and you'll see that it's a special occasion. But if you look a little deeper, you'll see that every 25th year, it is a year of Jubilee. Next year is the 25th of 2025. And the church expects to see a Jubilee like we've never seen before. She hadn't come to me until this afternoon. She had been on my mind the last few days because I just read this, but I marked all this down a couple of years ago. Sometimes God puts things on the shelf for us. But next year is 2025. And you know what? The church is on the eighth year. See, when the storm had to take his year and put it together, God is speaking that he's alive today. I believe within my spirit that they're popped out to me this afternoon. I said, oh my God, what are you fixing to do in 2025? Is the soul fixing to be saved like we've never seen before? Is the church fixing to bust open like we've never seen before? I believe Jubilee is here, and I believe within the next 2 months, God's fixing to prepare us to get ready for that Jubilee. That's why he said today, as I was walking in the grocery store, he said, are you prepared for the Jubilee? Church, I want to ask you tonight, are you prepared for the Jubilee? Says Jubilee is a special anniversary. You look it up, you look up spiritual Jubilee. In Hebrew, it means Yiddish, Yubal, and Jubal. The year at the end of the seven cycles. We're at the end of the year of the seven cycles. My, my, my. Are you getting this tonight? Are you in it? It says in the sabbatical year, honey, with a seventh year, which is the Sabbath, not the Sabbath, the Sabbath, which is a day of rest. Honey, we've been resting the last year. We've been resting, but we fixing to bust open the Word that God has been rolling out. We don't think it's going to touch anybody. We wonder why we come the Sabbath day. They come and sit in behind the four doors of this little old store, but Bill and Brother Michael, it's because God had a plan. God had a plan. He still got a plan. And with this Holy Ghost, with everything that's been coming against us, everything that's been coming our way, with this Holy Ghost, he's going to give a leap. He's got the rubber for it.
Give a leap.
needed to eat, Brother Michael. My, my, my. He's told the church, if we'll read it real close, what they need to do, how they need to eat, how they need to prepare.
Right.
Get ready. Get ready. Jubilee, if you look it up, the color of Jubilee is blue.
Right.
My, my, my. It's a bluish color. You look at the skies and what do you see? You see a blue sky. My, my, my. If you look around, Brother Michael, and people say, why are you happy for? Start saying, my name's Mike Zeman, Michael Zeman. The devil can't do me no harm. I'm preparing for that Jubilee that's coming around on that ship. Oh, my, my. I didn't mention this, but the 25th. My, is a silver anniversary. The 50th is a gold anniversary. The church is getting ready this coming year, next month, that we're going to be celebrating a silver anniversary. And the Jubilee is here, church. It's at the door. It's at the door. Knocking. Hey, I'm going to get an exit. Come on in, Jubilee. We ready for it. Why in the world am I going through so many things? Hey, can I tell you something?
Get prepared.
My, my, my. You say, oh, preacher, I've had trouble praying this last year. Hey, that's because you're getting ready to go into a Jubilee and the devil's fighting you with everything that
Come
he
on.
Has. Oh, preacher, I've had time. In trouble, getting my mind centered about the Lord. That's because he knows Jubilee's just around the corner. That's because he knows the church is on the move and he can't stop them.
That's right.
He's thinking, my, what have I done? What have I done? Oh, I tell you what, he messed up.
Right.
He's messed up. He's messed up because God has woke the church has woken up out of the spiritual wokeness that the world is trying to put them in, but they begin to see things with their own natural eyes, and then God started revealing some things through their spiritual eyes.
Right. That's right. Sure
has. Mm-hmm.
Come on.
Jubilee, I believe in ready to shout, church? Are you ready to stand up and say, God, I'm yours. God, I'm ready for it. I'm ready, Lord, for those loved ones. I'm ready for my enemies to be saved. I'm ready to win who I love. Who you want me to win for you. I'm ready for it. Jubilee is here. Get ready for it. Come on, church. Do you not understand what we're saying tonight? Jubilee is a time of shout. It's a time of rejoicing. Or whoever gets us home, you examine yourself tonight. And you ask yourself this, whether you be here or whether you be by way of earth tonight, you ask yourself, am I ready for a jubilee? Am I ready for the jubilee? Am I ready to shout? Am I ready to run with everything within me to run for the Lord? Am I truly ready? Try to ask yourself tonight. Jesus is on his way. But right now we got jubilee coming up.
Thank you.
believe. I was looking through my Bible, Sister Bonnie, and I showed Nora. I said, look, joy. Amen. God gave me a message a while back. Amen. And the Lord said I had to wait till all the church folks was here to preach it. Amen. But the joy of the Lord is our strength. Amen. The year of Jubilee. Church, God's trying to get us all ready. Amen. Listen, we're fixing to go into something. Sister Missy, honestly, I do believe. I told Sister Nora, hey, I ain't lost my faith one bit. Brother Austin, my faith has never got weak. I've held on to that promise. I've held on, Sister Bonnie. I still hold on to that promise. God's the only one that can put that picture in the sky, Brother Michael.
Right.
He's the only one that can put both those pictures in the sky and show. Listen, the first one he showed me was, I was thinking about it the other day. First one he showed me, Brother Wayne, was Jesus leaning over like he was watching over it. Sister Bonnie, if you look at it. Then the second one, he showed us the promise. Amen, and I've held on. Hey, it's been sold, it's been sold, it's been sold. But guess what? It's still sitting there. And guess what? While I was praying tonight, amen, I said, God, you're going to be in there. And there's going to be souls that's going to be saved. There's going to be chains that's going to be broke off, addictions off of people. There's going to be people sanctified and filled with heaven's sweet Holy Ghost. You say, Brother Miller, what are you talking about? 7 years. The year of Jubilee's coming. The year of Jubilee. God's had you work in this little vineyard long enough. I'm fixing to move you to the bigger vineyard. Why? Because he's going to send more people in, Sister Bonnie. Hallelujah. I had somebody tell me here a while back. Said, Brother Miller, I want to tell you something. She said, just hold on because your victory's coming. Just hold on. The vision that you have is coming. And she said, and I know somebody that can just go buy it for you and hand it to you. I said, you know what? I said, it's going to be debt free when we get it, Sister Bonnie. And she said, it's nobody but my uncle. Nobody but my uncle. He can do it. He likes to help little churches out. Hey, I pray God send that uncle this way. Ask me that good Samaritan, Brother Austin, that God said, I've got a good Samaritan. I own a cattle on 1,000 hills. I've got a good Samaritan out there that's going to come y'all's way. You know what Sister Nora said one night? She said, you know what God's going to do? God's going to have him to come right out here to this little church, and he's going to walk in and say, here's the keys. Go do. Hot off horse. Go do what you got to do for the Lord. You believe that? I believe it. God spoke to her, taught her. When God speaks, we listen. I know the year of Jubilee's coming. Church, we're going to blossom. We're going to grow like we've never grown before. Brother Daniel, and God's got to work. You got to work in the vineyards. Brother Austin, you got to work in the vineyards. He said, work in the vineyard. I was thinking about this, Brother Wayne, and you was preaching. We've all been working in the vineyard. Amen. We all started out 7 years ago working in the vineyard, getting everything ready. Like I was talking this morning, Sister Connie putting that tape on those chairs, not knowing that God had something in store. Amen. We didn't know what God was going to do. But I'm still holding on to that promise. I'm still holding on to what that girl told me. Amen. I'm still holding on to it. And you know what? God can speak to that girl and she can go to her uncle and
say, Uncle, that little church has been through a lot. And I believe that God wants you to bless that church. You believe that? I believe that. Amen. I believe that. Stood up here and sung the altar thing tonight for Sister Nora again. That gives Sister Nora praise. Amen. She's proud of that. She loves that. She enjoys that. Sister Bonnie ain't by herself now. Praise the Lord. Amen. God is working. Amen. He's getting us ready. Amen. Praise the Lord. Anybody want to give God some praise tonight? Anybody want to give God some thanks?
If God brings you out of the drug house, don't go back to the drug house.
Because if you go back to that drug house, then it's going to get back on touch with you. Amen. I talked to this girl that was a drug addict, and she said, if I'm not around it, I don't get high, but if I'm around it, I want it. Amen. That's what happens. When they get around it, they get that. They get a whiff of it. Oh, I want it. Amen. Or they get that spirit, and that spirit draws it to them. Amen. We need to be witnesses, Lord. Somebody else will give God some praise. Yes, amen. Somebody else. Remember, Bonnie told us, she said she built an altar in her house, and she pray around that altar. Sometimes we get our mind on something, and we forget to pray at that altar, or we'll get so tired we just go lay down and forget to pray. Amen. I was thinking about Daniel and Sister Misty and then them babies. Amen. They said they read them Bible stories to them, and let them watch them Bible movies, amen, and little story movies, amen, about the Bible. They'll learn, amen. That's how I learned about the Bible, amen. We sit down at the breakfast table, Brother Daniel, every morning before school, we had to read a chapter in the Bible. And then before we went to bed, we sat and read with Mom and Dad. We all read, had to take turns and read it. And we learn the Bible. And then before we go to sleep, Brother Austin, we think we get to go to sleep. Here comes Mom in there with them little blue Bible story books. And that men come around selling the doors. And she'll come in there and she'll start reading them Bible stories to us. And then we get to go off to sleep. I didn't, because she'd get me up and say, come in here and sit on the couch while I pray. And she'd start praying. And Sister Missy, the Holy Ghost, would fall on her and she would be laid out in the floor, and I'm sitting there on the couch trying to off to sleep, and she'd be praying, and I listened to her, and she would pray for all the people in the church, and she would pray for the ones that wasn't in the church, and she would pray for her kids that were lost and wasn't saved. And I said, Mama, I said, tomorrow night I don't have to come in here and pray with you, do I? She said, yep, you're my prayer warrior. You come in here and sit beside of her and pray. Amen. But listen, I learned what God was showing my mama. We come home from church one night, and he showed her, such funny, she come out on the back porch, and the neighbors were all looking. She was looking up in the sky, and she hollered, come, come, Kenneth, come, kids, see what I'm seeing. And we go out there, and we're looking. Mama, we can't see nothing. She said, but look, and we looked. And she's the only one could see it, Brother Daniel, but she was seeing Jesus kneeling down beside the rock praying. Remember in the garden where he knelt down and he prayed? That's what she was seeing, and God was showing her that vision. Amen. Sometimes God will show you a vision, but the other person can't see that vision. I took a picture of this. If y'all seen the big bright star that's been shining bright here lately, that's the Bethlehem star. I took a picture of it the other night, Brother Daniel, and I kept seeing little white things flying. around in the sky, and they were making little circles, and I took a picture of that. And then I took a video of it. That's what you showed me, Lord. And you know, the Bible said that we see the great cloud of witnesses above us. I thought, Lord, is that what you're showing me? That they're flying around. Amen. You know what he also said, Brother Wayne? He said, I'll send the angels down. And the angels are going to minister. And guess what, Brother Austin? He said, we're going to judge them. We're going to judge the world. We're going to judge your mercy. We're going to be the ones who gets to judge them. The Christians are the ones that's going to get to do the judging. Amen. And I thought about that. Amen. How God shows us these little things. Somebody else want to testify? All right. Amen. We want to tell our live stream. We appreciate y'all. We love you. Get ready for the year of Jubilee. Amen. It's coming, church. It's coming. Amen. We love you. Amen. Listen, if you ain't got a home church and you're looking for a home church, and people say, well, Brother Miller, why do you keep saying that? Because there's somebody out there that's looking for a home church. There's somebody out there that's hungry for the true word of God. There's somebody out there, the Bible said that there's going to be a family. For the true word of God. People are going to be hungry for the word of God. Amen. Listen, if you want to come and try us out, we're out here at 1499 Merciful Road. You can't miss us. As soon as you come out, like going towards Somerset, there's a Shell gas station right there. As soon as you pass that Shell station, we're right here on the right, same side. Amen. Like for you to come and try us out. If you don't like us, you don't have to stay. Amen. But if you do, we want you to stay and be with us. Amen. Be a part of our church. Amen. Have service with us. Amen. We love you. We appreciate you. Amen. Till Thursday night. May God be with you is our prayers.